and welcome to another episode of Turning the Page podcast. Listening to others can be frustrating, but when we listen to ourselves, we might find the key to compassionate listening to others. Going deep, where life is indeed happening, requires us to stop and be slow, be quick to listen to yourself. I wonder why I was getting so frustrated with them. I'd listened to them, shared some wisdom, and nothing had changed. Why wouldn't they follow through and do what I wanted them to do? Ever been in that situation? I had listened to them, you know, and done everything, but they still didn't sort of follow through and do the stuff we suggested we should do. You know, surface level listening will be okay for most of our communication needs, but for the deep, essential soul questions, it takes discipline to slow down and give focused, attentive space for the other. In the Bible, a writer by the name of James gives this advice: "Understand this, my dear brothers and sisters, you must be all quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry." Now, why would James include an emotion such as anger in a sentence about communication? Well, I believe that anger and frustration are often related to not having expectations met. You know, I asked my son to wash the dishes. He agrees, but doesn't do it. And I get the feelings of anger and frustration. The expectation of clean dishes wasn't met. He didn't listen well to understand that this was actually really important to me. And I didn't listen well to understand that he had an important school assignment due tomorrow. Had we both been quick to listen and slow to speak, we might have negotiated the problem a better way. The conversation might have gone along these lines: "Would you be able to wash the dishes?" "Yes, I can, but I need to work on my assignment for the next hour. Is that okay?" You know, if you're feeling angry and frustrated with someone, then I would suggest that you might not be listening deep enough. Do you listen to yourself? What are your motivations when you come to listen to others? Here are some suggestions. Perhaps you want to fix them. Perhaps you want to solve the problems they have. Perhaps you want to make your life easier. Maybe you want to manipulate them to do something for you. You know, we enter into conversations for many different reasons, some of them not so noble. So the first person we need to listen to is ourselves and what is going on inside of us. And this is a discipline of laying aside our agenda for the sake of somebody else. Listening to the other is going to require slowing down on your behalf and asking questions with no agenda other than to understand. You may want to ask these questions. "Tell me more. I want to understand. I didn't quite get that. Can you explain it a bit further? Look, this is what I heard. Did I get that right?" And watch the tone of your voice. Note your body language. Anything that expresses anger or frustration will just shut the connection down and shut down the communication. Now, the writer James wasn't just talking about communication. He was focusing on connection. That a conversation would go to a place where there was a deep connection of soul to soul. And this is what we long and crave for. Someone who will get us. Having another wanderer who can share our journey. You know, it's a quote by Larry Crabb. Real encouragement occurs when words are spoken from a heart of love to another's recognized fear. Over the next week, listen for signs of anger and frustration in your life. How many of them are due, in part, to not have been deeply listened to? Now, you can't control others, but you can take responsibility to be a good listener to yourself. Look for moments in conversations where you can take the conversation into connection. Ask further questions where you seek out more clarification. Some quotes. "Competent people do a good job. Dentists, plumbers, school teachers, and technicians. But it is inadequate people, people who know that they are inadequate, that become effectively usable by God, by the Spirit of God and the work of soul care." Larry Crabb. To be more aware of the other person, first, become more aware of yourself. Without self-awareness, self cannot be laid aside in order to listen. David Riddell. Listen to respond to others with honest, open questions instead of counsel or corrections. With such questions, we help hear each other into deeper speech. Parker Palmer. When you speak to me about your deepest questions, you do not want to be fixed or saved. You want to be seen and heard, to have your truth acknowledged and honored. Parker Palmer. Good work is relational, and its outcomes depend on what we are able to evoke from each other. Parker Palmer. It is usually most helpful to ask questions that are more about the person than about the problem. Parker Palmer. Questions to answer. Why do you think we are more likely to be quick to speak and slow to listen? 2. Describe the aspects of a conversation that you felt turned into a connection. 3. How much vulnerability is required of the listener to listen deeply? So I hope you have a good week, and I hope you listen. Listen to yourself. Listen to the motivations you have for listening to others. And dig deep into this and listen well. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this podcast, and just a big thanks to all my supporters who give a little bit each month and support this podcast and Turning the Page. If you'd like to become part of that fantastic community, head over to turningthepage.info/support. And I look forward to talking to you next week. If you found this helpful, drop me an email. Love to hear from my listeners and readers. My email address is barry@turningthepage.info. Thanks.